Hey everybody, how's it going? Check it out. We're going to go out and take some photos today. So I thought I'd give you about, you know, three or four, maybe even five or six, maybe seven or eight different tips of things you can do when you go out and take photos. See, because the thing about photography and photography related adventures are everybody's got an opinion on what you should carry. Everybody's got an opinion on what you should carry. All of that stuff. And here's the deal. It's really personal. So whatever you decide you want to carry and how you want to carry it and for whatever pictures or whatever style of photography you want to do, purely up to you. So these are my opinions of what I do to help me out when I go out. Now let me go ahead and set the scene for you. When we go out and take pictures, or photos, we go out to different places, typically out in the desert. You know, we drive out there, sometimes we have to hike, sometimes we have to do a bunch of different things. So, you know, this is just kind of like what I do and what I carry. And here's the scoop. I'm getting a little older, I don't want to carry 100 pounds of stuff, so I don't. So what I found is these are things that I do that make it easier on me. Because I'll tell you this, a 5-pound lens at the beginning of the day becomes a 50-pound lens at the end of the day. So in order to be able to keep up, I've sort of lightened the load for a lot of things that I do. And I don't spend a lot of money on photography stuff. I've been doing photography for a while. So these are some tips that you might find useful. And like I said, these are all my opinions. So, and I will say this, if you have any comments, suggestions, concerns, leave them in the comments below in a little area down there, and I'll be sure to take a look and answer them. So yeah. So anyway, here we go. Hey everybody, how you doing? If you like the video, hit subscribe. I appreciate it.
I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut butter.
Okay, so here's the first tip. The first tip is about storage. Okay, you can go out and get one of these nice little Pelican cases that pretty much the only thing it does is hold memory cards, right? I mean, that's cool and all. I do a little bit differently. What I actually do is I take these Altoid 10s that I've used and I've sanded down and painted because I need projects to do to keep me occupied. And check it out. I put stuff in here. Since I use a lot of small cameras, I have a small camera batteries. They're all put in here so I don't lose them. There's an adapter for an SD card, anyway, or micro SD card, but that's pretty much what I do. Put my extra batteries for my smaller cameras in there. This one's getting kind of used there. So anyway, I use my gear, right? And I have this super sweet, look at this, isn't that cool? Anyway, I have a nice little, this is technically a bracelet, that I use to actually keep it secure. So that's about storage. So, you know, 20 bucks for this, 2 bucks for this, right? I do carry my small cameras. If you'll notice, here's another tip for you. Put the freaking wrist strap on here, man. If you don't want to drop your gear, use the wrist strap. Yeah. All right, extra battery. Here's a tip. I always label them S100. I have multiple cameras that use the same battery. So when I do have multiple cameras that use the same battery, I make sure I label them. Like this one, this battery purely fits the S100 and the S100, and that's it. So it says S100 on it, so I can look at a glance and see. And some people's like, well, when, why are you gonna write on your battery like that, man? Because it's mine and I don't care. When I wanna carry bigger batteries, or I need to carry bigger batteries or bigger gear, I use an eyeglass case. This is one I got for free when I got a pair of eyeglasses. I got a video camera battery and my EOS M battery. And I can put larger batteries in here as well. And when you zip it all shut, guess what? Safe. Carry a stupid little tripod. This little tripod works great. I don't need a big tripod. This tripod works as a tabletop tripod, wrap it around a tree tripod, basically a whatever you want tripod, and it also acts as a camera stabilizer because I happen to do videos, because I make videos on YouTube, just in case you didn't know. And if you did know, thank you very much. But if you didn't know, check out my videos. I got a whole bunch of them. So there you go. Public service announcement, commercial over. Monopod. Monopods are great. My monopod has this little itty bitty ball head tripod on the top that I use. It also doubles as a walking stick. Yeah, and a snake hitting stick. And a poking stick, because if you're a dude, you gotta have a poking stick. Alright, here's the next one. Let me show you my camera bag. Kinda goes back to storage again. There it is. Okay, here's the deal. If you buy a camera bag, like an actual camera bag, it says Canon or Nikon or whatever on it, you're a sucker. Don't buy a camera bag. Camera bags are a waste of time or a waste of money. You'll never find the perfect camera bag to hold all your gear. You just won't. It's a quest that you'll go on that you'll never win. So what you gotta do is you gotta find something that actually works and will cover most of your goals and stick with it. And what I found for me is using a backpack, it has become the perfect camera bag because I can customize it for what I want. So if you don't wanna use a camera bag, or since I'm telling you not to use a camera bag, what are you gonna do? Use a camera bag insert, right? They come in different types and different sizes. I happen to like the 8 case brand. I can put all sorts of gear in here. See? divider pockets, lots of places to put different stuff, flaps to cover different things, and the cool thing is it actually pops up and you can put taller stuff in there. Look at the size of that thing. And it has a cinch top to help keep the weather out. So here's a smaller camera bag insert made by Abe Case. Can you see in here? Probably not. Let me show you. Like dumping all my stuff. Alright, I have my 2.8 inch loop. I got my EOS M in here. I got a big tall lens with no lens cover on the back, which I need to find out the lens body cap. I got a, and I even have a video camera, right? See, a little video camera hiding down in there. So what you do is you take your camera bag insert and you put it in your giant backpack. This giant backpack has everything I need. I can put the camera bag down at the bottom. It's got keepers in the back to actually hold like things like jackets and stuff like that. Nylon mesh to put other stuff in. Other pockets to put other stuff. I can put everything in here. Lenses, all sorts of other things. A flashlight, right? And cool, here's a front pocket. But down at the bottom, I have another pocket. I could actually put, if I really want to, a longer lens down here, like a 70 to 200. Very nice, right? Yeah. Got water bottle pockets on the side to hold my water bottle. It also will hold my tripod or the monopod. Everything cinches down. This bag from LA Police Gear was $29. I've had this bag for 4 years now. I've worn this thing out. I carry this thing everywhere. And here's the cool part. See this little pouch in the back right here? Well, number one, it's padded to help keep my back from getting sweaty, but it also will hold my 17-inch laptop. Or if you're somebody else and you have a 13-inch MacBook, it'll hold it in here. It'll hold a tablet. It holds all of that stuff. So once I load this backpack up, I can pretty much put all my camera gear, a change of clothes, food, carry water, tripod, the whole deal, $29. This bag is super heavy duty. So don't buy a camera bag. Camera bags are for suckers. Buy a backpack and buy a camera bag insert. Customize the inserts towards what you want to do. Today I'm not going too many places, so I don't need a lot of gear. I just need a couple different things. Multi-purpose equipment is my next tip. This little handle right here with a quarter 20, right, came off my Zoom H4N. What? It also, since it's quarter 20, works on everything. So if I have another video camera, or if I want to use my S100, which is a great little pocket camera. I know there's been lots of newer versions, but I still like this one because it still works great. Everything screws in. Same thing with my little action cameras. It doesn't say GoPro on it because, you know what, I'm not paying GoPro prices for it. If I lose this, I don't care. I actually care more about this because this is kind of useful. So there you go. Multi-purpose equipment. Small pocket camera, not a big deal. It doesn't really count as a tip, but I just happen to like it. Storage, utilize storage, right? Oh, and one more thing. I'm sorry, two more things. Bam, here's my other Altoid stands. I forgot to put it on the table. I also carry stuff in here. That's like an all day sort of cold, non-drowsy, daytime cold medicine type thing. I got a cough drop. I have some flu stuff. Here's some antihistamine for allergies. And I usually have like aspirin and other things like that. This is very small. I carry it with me because sometimes you get out there and you forget stuff. And if you carry it in your bag with you the whole time, you ever get out where you're going to go take photos and you feel rough, you got something. See? Works pretty good, right? Simple. Simple is easy. I don't need to spend a lot of money and I'm not gonna. So, oh, and here's a little something too. If you're going to go out on the weekend and take pictures, right, and you're doing it for fun and you're not getting paid, you're not going on a photo shoot. So stop telling everybody you're going out on a photo shoot. Right? Because a lot of people say, I'm a professional photographer and this weekend I went out on a photo shoot. And they went out and took pictures. Call it what it is, man. Anyway, that's just a little rant from me to you, but that's okay. Whoa, almost killed myself. And here's my last tip. This, can you see this? That's how much that is. I think it's 10 cents, right? Can you see it? Yeah, this was 10 cents from Walmart's. This is an American sort of cup holder, right? A beer koozie, if you will, or can cooler, whatever you want to call it. So, but check this out. I like to use these because I got the little tubs on the bottom. I put my fingers in here like this, and then I push up, and what pops out of here? Look at that, a nice 28 millimeter lens. Yeah, this is one of my favorite lenses. I use this lens quite a bit, and yeah. So, when I'm done using it, I put it back inside the little beer koozie. Yes. But yeah, there you go. That is my 10 cent lens protector. Neoprene, easy access, stores and gives a little bit of protection. So if this comes out of my case and somewhere in my bag floating around, it is still protected. So there you go. Those are some really helpful tips, or at least I think they're helpful. If you think they're helpful, do a little thumbs up and subscribe. If you have any comments or suggestions down there, maybe some tips and tricks that you do, let me know. Hey man, because I'm always open to that kind of thing, and I always like little tips and tricks to get things going. Because, you know, at the end of the day, if you're going out there taking photos or doing video or whatever it is you're doing, whatever gear you're using, none of that stuff really matters. Just go out and do it, right? So, I mean, I really like to go out and do that sort of thing, especially on the weekends and, you know, because I have another job too. But, yeah, there you go. Now, you can really go overboard with this sort of thing and really plan for everything. Then you wind up carrying around a 1,000-pound backpack, and that's not really what this is all about. So those are some of the things that I carry to make my life easier, just quick and easy tips. And since I was packing the bag up to go outside anyway and head on out to the desert and take some pictures of stuff, like maybe some, I don't know. But yeah, there you go. So comments, suggestions, concerns, let me know. If you like this video, thumbs up and subscribe. If you do subscribe, turn on post notifications, because if you subscribe and you don't turn on post notifications, then you never know when somebody makes a new video. Yeah, it's a thing. Yeah. So anyway, see you later. Take it easy. Bye-bye.
I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut butter. I like...